Hey guys, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we are going to compare and estimate different lengths. Let's compare the lengths of these two lines. We know how to order by length, so which of these lines is longer? Yeah, the purple one. But by how much? Well, we can use our ruler to compare the measured lengths of these lines. Now, with our rulers in inches, we can measure the purple line at 10 inches, and we measure the green line at 6 inches. How many inches longer is the purple line? Well, now we just have a subtraction problem. 10 inches minus 6 inches is 4 inches. So the purple line is 4 inches longer than the green line. Let's compare the length of these pencils in centimeters. For the long pencil, I make sure the eraser is right at the 0 centimeter mark. And then I find where the tip of my pencil is on my ruler. It's at the 15 centimeter mark. So this pencil is 15 centimeters long. Now what about the bottom pencil? I make sure my eraser is lined up with the 0 mark and trace down to the tip of my pencil and see it is at 7 centimeters. So I can say that the top pencil is longer than the bottom pencil by 15 centimeters minus 7 centimeters by 8 centimeters. Now if this line is 1 inch long, about how long is the squirrel? Since the question asks about how long, we know that we are finding an estimation. An estimation is a number that is close to the actual number, but probably not exactly the same. And that is okay. We put thought and calculations into estimations, so they are not guesses. So we are going to use this line with a length of 1 inch to determine how many inches long the squirrel is. I can do this by drawing a copy of this line right next to it. So if I draw one of these right next to it, it's about that long, huh? And then I can draw another one about that long, and it looks like I can fit about one more. So it looks like my squirrel, if each of these are 1 inch, and I have 4 of them, my squirrel is about 4 inches long. Now in this problem, we see the red flower has a height of 16 centimeters, and we're trying to find the height of this yellow flower. So let's start by looking at the red flower. Let's find about the halfway point. Looks like it would be about right there, right? And if we know that the whole flower is 16 centimeters, then what would be just half? Well, 16 divided by 2 would give me 8 centimeters, and that's my halfway point. So then this up here is also 8 centimeters. So now if I look over at my yellow flower, does it look like my yellow flower is less than half of my red flower? Not really. I can't say for certain. Does it look like my yellow flower is more than half the height of my red flower? Again, I can't really tell for certain. And if I trace my estimate halfway point across with just a dashed line here, it looks like my yellow flower is about half as tall as my red flower. So we can estimate the height of our yellow flower as the halfway distance of our red flower, which we found was 8 centimeters. So we can say our yellow flower has a height of about 8 centimeters. So this is my dog here, and this is my friend's dog over here. Now I know that my dog has a height of 30 inches. I've measured him. But my friend doesn't know the height of her dog. She's never measured him. But we're going to use my dog and try to estimate the height of my friend's dog. So if I know that my dog has a height of 30 inches, does it look like my dog is half the height of my friend's dog? This would be about the halfway mark of my friend's dog, right? Looks like my dog is taller than the halfway point of my friend's dog. In fact, if I take the whole height of my dog and I do a little dashed line over to here to my friend's dog, my dog hits at about that mark right there. Well, now I know that this whole height is 30 centimeters here on my friend's dog, because that's the height of my dog. So how much taller is my friend's dog? Now I need to know what this little bit up here. It sort of looks like this little bit up here could fit a few times down here, right, in the height of my dog. Like we did with the squirrel, how many times would this distance fit inside the distance that we know, the 30 centimeters? Well, looks like I could draw a line about here, and that would be about the same. And it looks like I could draw about one more. So now we have this, 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 and this distance. If we added all of those numbers up together, we would have the height of my friend's dog. So that distance, that X that we don't know, looks like it fits in 30 centimeters three times. So what number goes into 30 three times? Does 15 go into 30 three times? Well, we know 15 plus 15 is equal to 30, and that's only two times. So it's a number that's less than 15. What about 10? If I added 10 together three times, I'd get 30, right? So it looks like each of these is 10 centimeters. So that means my friend's dog is 10 centimeters taller than my dog. And if we have 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10, do you know what that equals? 40 centimeters. And that's how tall we're estimating my friend's dog to be. Great job learning how to compare and estimate lengths. It can be a little tricky, but it's pretty fun. Now practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.